Hi, my name is Chintan and in this video today we are going to look at how to model the floating tower by DFA Studios. This is located in Manhattan, New York. Let's take a look at how to model this inside of SketchUp. Let's go. Okay, so let's start by making a polygon. So go to draw and then shapes and then click on polygon. Then type in 18s on your keyboard to change the number of sides to 18. And then enter a radius of 15 meters or 15,000 millimeters. Then select this and make it a component by pressing the G key. Now drag a copy of this component using the move tool along with the control key and then type a distance of 3500 mm. Now for the purpose of reference in the future, make a line from the center of this component down in the Z direction. Now use the rotate tool and rotate the component on top by 10 degrees, which in this case is the midpoint of the segment directly below it. Now join these two points using the line tool. Now rotate 17 copies of this using the rotate tool. And then type 17x on your keyboard. Now make a selection like this and deselect this line and then make this a group. Now select these 18 segments and drag them upwards in the Z direction and then rotate them by 10 degrees so that they align like this. Now select all these 4 groups and components and make 14 copies of this using the move tool along with the control key. So using the move tool, drag a copy and then type 14x on your keyboard to make 14 copies of this. This would give us something like this. Now edit the polygon component and give it a thickness of 300 mm using the push-pull tool. Now select that and make it a group, and after grouping, edit this and offset this face by 1500 mm. Then select that face and cut the face and then paste in place. Then give it some thickness using the push-pull tool. Or we can change the number of sides to 36 so that we double it, that it becomes more rounded. And then we can use the push-pull tool. Now we can triple click to select it all and make it a group using Ctrl plus G. Then if we use the backslash, we can hide the rest of the model and then delete the top face and the bottom face like this. Also selecting this, we can give this a glass material. Now switch to top view using Ctrl plus 1 as a shortcut and the parallel projection view using the tilde key. Now making a cross selection, select all these components except the diagrid segments and then make them a group. Then select everything with Ctrl A and then deselect the group that we just made and then make a single group containing all the diagrid segments. Now enter this group by double clicking on it. Now select every group inside it and explode it. Now double click on the one spiral segment, then select it and right click to weld it. If you don't have that, you can use the TID weld plugin. And then with that being selected, make that a component. Now select everything and deselect that component and delete them. Now you can unhide the rest of the model as we need to rotate copies of that component we just created. Now rotate a copy of it like this using the rotate tool along with the control key. And then type 17x to make 17 copies. Now select the group with the staggered components, copy it and paste it in place using Ctrl Shift V. Then right click and flip along the red axis, and that should give us this diagrid structure that we are looking for. Now we need to edit this component, so double click to edit and make a copy of it using the move tool like this. Now selecting both of these spirals around and using the curve wheel loft plugin, which is a free plugin, we can make a surface out of them. So if we reduce the number of segments to 1, we can get a surface. Now triple click to select this whole surface, and using the joint push pull plugin, give it a thickness of 300 mm. Now to make some railings, we can use the profile builder tool or we can use the follow me. So in this video we are showing the follow me. So select this edge, copy it and paste it outside the group in the same place, then offset it by 150 mm, then delete the original edge and make a copy of this at a height of 1200 mm. Now delete the face inside and delete the original face. Now with this whole curve selected, make a rectangle using the rectangle tool, and if we press control key on the keyboard while drawing, we'll draw the rectangle from its center. So draw a rectangle, and then with the curve being selected, press the follow me tool. I have set up a shortcut control plus F for that, so it would give us this railing. We can then group it and make copies of it using the move tool. So make 4 copies by typing divide by 4. So now the basic form of our building is sort of complete. We just need to finalize it by doing some changes and making the pillars at the bottom. Also, the top component is sort of missing with the roof, so we can add a roof or we can just delete these windows. So we can delete the window group. Now using the line tool, from this point that lies on the red axis, draw a line for 2 meters. Now it's important that you draw it on any axis because we need it to manipulate the line segments further. Then draw a line by 8 meters and then move it along the axis by 4 meters like this. Then double click to select this segment and rotate a copy of it like this. Similarly, again make a copy of it, with that the whole segment being selected to this point. Now using the line tool, we need to join these points as we cannot manipulate the points directly inside of SketchUp. So we'll make lines and then we'll use the scale tool to scale them closer. Also, we can use the tape measure tool to make a guide point for 500 mm. Then we can select both of these lines, use the scale tool, and with control being selected, we can scale it from the middle and move the point closer like this, and then move this point along the red axis until it's aligned, and then delete the guide point using the eraser tool and delete these line segments also. Now draw a line for 2 meters in the Z direction like this and copy it over here and over here as well. Now to give it some curves, we need to use the arc tool and draw an arc from the midpoint of the upper segment like this, and over here also. Similarly for the bottom segment, draw an arc like this, and over here also like this. Now we have these curves and we just need to make a profile and follow it along this path. So for that, let's make a rectangle on this surface. So let's make a rectangle of 600 mm by 600 mm. Then double click to select it and from this midpoint, place it over here like this. Now make copies of this rectangle that we just created over here and add the other segment as well. Now double click to select this curve and using the shortcut control plus F, which is for the follow me tool, we can make a column out of this. So select the curve, then deselect the rectangle, and then click the follow me shortcut and that should give us this column. Now triple click to select this whole column and group it using Ctrl plus G. Now using the rotate tool, we can make copies of this. So rotate a copy of this by 60 degrees and then type 5x on your keyboard to make 5 copies. And this would give us the famous columns of the DFA tower. Now select everything and group it and just move it upwards. Also, we delete this line that we made earlier for reference. Now select everything and we can place it over the origin. So open a bracket, type comma comma 0 so that it gets placed on the origin. And this is how you model the floating tower by DFA Studios inside of SketchUp. Now you can use this technique to model any of your forms by manipulating the number of sides of the polygon that you decide to make, and then making a diagonal structure along that, and then supporting it with columns for the structure and using that structure as a part of the form itself. I hope you learned something valuable from this video. If you did, please subscribe, hit like. If you have any doubts, you can join our Discord server or leave them in the comments. And I would see you in the next video. Peace.